And here is the Writer's Almanac for Wednesday, the 17th of July, 2019. It's the birthday of Earl Stanley Gardner, who created the character Perry Mason, the attorney. Earl Stanley Gardner, born in Malden, Massachusetts, 1889. He was a typist at a law firm. He learned legal terminology that way. And though he had no formal training, he passed the California bar exam, and he joined a law firm where he was very bored by legal practice itself, and he started writing crime stories for pulp magazines. His first Perry Mason novel was The Case of the Velvet Claws in 1933, which established Perry Mason's basic MO. He proved his client's innocence by implicating another character who soon confessed. On this day in 1867, the first college of dentistry opened, Harvard Dental School, establishing dentistry as a branch of medicine. Until then, you learned dentistry by apprenticing yourself to a dentist. Some people still went to a barber or even a blacksmith to have a tooth pulled, and you might replace it with a tooth from a cadaver or dentures made of hard rubber. It's the birthday of the editor Ernest Percival Rhys, born in London, 1859, who developed a series of inexpensive works of classic literature, 1,000 titles in all, which he called Everyman's Library. It's the birthday of the Belgian astronomer Georges Lemaître, born in Charleroi, Belgium, 1894. He proposed the Big Bang theory, maintaining that the universe originated with a gigantic explosion of what he called a small superatom, and that the universe is constantly expanding. And it was on this day in 1936 the Spanish Civil War began, the right-wing nationalists trying to overthrow the government. It was the first major threat of fascism in Europe. Here's a poem by Raymond Burns, Personal Effects. The lawyer told him to write a letter to accompany the will to prevent potential discord over artifacts valued only for their sentiment. His wife treasures a watercolor by her father. Grandmama's spoon stirs the oatmeal every morning. Some days he wears his father's favorite tie. He tries to think of things that could be tokens of his days, binoculars that transport bluebirds through his cataracts, a frayed fishing vest with pockets full of feathers brightly tied, the little fly rod he can still manipulate in forest thickets, a sharp-tined garden fork, heft and handle fit for him, a springy spruce kayak paddle, a retired leather satchel. He writes his awkward note, trying to dispense with gray, some well-worn clutter, easily discarded in another generation. But what he wishes to bequeath are items never owned, a Chopin etude wafting from his wife's piano on the scent of morning coffee, seedling peas poking into April, monarch caterpillars infesting milkweed leaves, a light brown doe alert in purple asters, a full moon rising in October, hunting hat orange in ebony sky, sunlit autumn afternoons that flutter through the heart like falling leaves. A poem by Raymond Burns, Personal Effects, from his collection Waters Deep, A Great Lakes Poetry Anthology, published by Split Rock Review and used by permission here on The Writer's Almanac. Be well, do good work, and keep in touch.